I mean, one of my inspirations, I have a lot of, I call them my friends in heaven, but one of them is Saint Faustina. And she has a little passage where she describes exactly what you said. She said it was the end of the day and she was just completely exhausted. And she was also sickly. She had health issues, but she was just such a wholehearted soul for the Lord. But she said she felt, you know, like a warrior, just completely depleted at the end of the day with not an ounce of energy left. And when you read this, you know, you're inspired because, you know, she's giving all she has. Right. And I think there's nothing we want more at the end of our life when we're coming before the judgment throne to be able to say, I have fought a good fight. Right. I finished my course. I kept the faith, you know, and, you know, laziness never feels good inside. Like, I mean, obviously we need legitimate rest. We need to recreate. A person needs to know how to chill at times, you know, but overall, especially I think as men, you know, I think as men, there's something about, just like the quote you shared, Father Heilman, about just putting it all on the field, like just giving all we have, that causes us something to burn inside, you know, the human spirit with God's spirit, you know. So yeah,
I want to insert this too, because yes, men need to lead the way in this, but I got to tell you, I happen to be the chaplain for homeschool families, and they're all open to life, and I'm watching these mothers that I don't know where they get all that energy. I mean, holy cow. They are, and they do it with this big, bright smile on their face. They just love what they're doing. And it's so inspirational. And you know, at the end of the day, they're just exhausted, but it's just a joyful exhaustion, right, Father? When you're working your heart out for a good cause, exhausted on the battle, victorious. That's what Vince Lombardi said. There's a joy that you can't describe when that happens. Isn't that true?
I've always said that the wealthiest people are people who found their mission in life. Like when you're describing these mothers, they're giving all they have because they know they're doing what they were created to do. Everything they do has meaning.
Yes.
It's fulfilling. And to me, when someone finds his mission in life, there's a drive, you know, like for me as a pastor, I love serving my people. I find the more I pour myself out, it's almost like the more energy I have. And
right.
A lot of people don't realize that laziness is exhausting. When we give ourselves over to the vice of laziness, our spirit, the drive within us, it's like it's depleted. And we lose our spiritual energy, our vitality. But when we're doing the work of God, it's like something burns inside of us. And yes, as human beings, we still do need legitimate rest, a good night's sleep.
You got to recuperate.
But and the thing is you look at people like say the three wise men. To me, they're a great icon. Here they are going on a dangerous long journey, driven by this calling and guided by heaven, you know, and they're just, they won't stop until they find the treasure, our Lord Jesus Christ. And to me, when a man finds his God-given call, his mission, it's thrilling because now you have a reason to get out of bed in the morning. You know, you have a reason to keep going. And there are some people, unfortunately, they haven't discovered that yet in their life for some reason. And I my heart goes out to those people, you know, like I for people like that, I would say, listen, get on your knees and beg God, say, God, show me what you made me for. Like, show me in this little short window of life on planet Earth, like what I'm supposed to do. Because when we discover our mission and our calling, it changes everything.
Father Mark, what would you say to those who believe that they feel they've discovered their mission and their mission has to do with basically themselves? in that my mission is to make as much money as I can. My mission is to be comfortable. My mission is to just enjoy life for me, as opposed to my mission is to somehow make a gift of myself and serve. And I know, I mean, there's a major distinction within a heart to understand that. And I just can't imagine standing before God and that it would go well for any of us to say, Lord, I fought the fight well, and I made myself comfortable, and I made myself lots of money, and I made myself lots of pleasure and comfort and excess. I didn't do much for others, but I felt pretty good about myself while I was there, even though I was somewhat miserable inside because, you know, I'm not, you know, I mean, I think it goes much better to say, Lord, I fought the fight well, and I gave of myself. You know, like Father Heilman, you mentioned about the homeschool mothers, or we homeschool. I watch my wife homeschool 5 kids, you know, 4 boys and a daughter. And I mean, I helped, obviously I did. I did. But sometimes we homeschool dad, you're just the principal. You didn't do anything. No, I did some stuff. I did some stuff. But my wife covered it most all the time. And I've, like you said, there's a mission oriented something there that is just beautiful and exhausting. But if I guess, Father Mark, your thoughts on that difference between standing before God and my mission was me, or my mission was finding Christ in others and serving. What do you say? How do you break that down?
Well, I mean, I think it's a universal experience, even among non-believers. I mean, I've watched motivational videos that are not even Christian, where the person is saying, listen, you have to make a gift of yourself in some way. Right. I mean, it's a universal truth. Selfish people aren't happy. And even the pagans know that. And we as Christians should know this all the more. Like, we as Christians have no excuse. You know, no greater love is there than to lay down your life for your friends. He who loses his life finds it. You know, I have not come to be served, but to serve. And so, the beautiful thing is God in his mercy, and I'm convinced of this, a person who is simply pursuing his own selfish interests doesn't have deep peace.
Right.
They might have the passing pleasures, but so many of them, I mean, we see it, like the Hollywood wealthy movie stars who have the most beautiful, whatever, girlfriends and the wealth and the fame, so many of them, their lives, I mean, some of them end up in suicide. So many of these people, they're sad. They're abusing drugs, and it's a testament. It's like, how in the world? Like, I don't want to name any names, but you think of some of these super rich, successful, beautiful people, and they're miserable, and they get into trouble. And you think to yourself, how in the world could someone like you, who has everything? Be so miserable, fall into that kind of a state. And in the Bible, there's a whole section called wisdom literature. There's the wisdom books. And wisdom says the beginning of wisdom is get wisdom. And for a person to not slow down enough in their life to just look back and say, well, listen, what's going to make me happy? Because even a young person typically knows that things of this world don't ultimately satisfy. So I don't know if that answers your question.
No, I think you're right. I think this is the very basic point that selfish people are in the really down deep inside are not happy, because there's just something that misses the point, because we're not created. I always say, just like we're created, the body is created 75-ish percent-ish. Did I say that right? 75%-ish water. So you need to be hydrated. You can go roughly 3 days, give or take. And if you don't have water, you're going to start really going downhill fast, and you'll die within several days or so without water. You need to be hydrated. You know, we talk about, they put an IV in someone's, inject the right kind of just minerals and so forth into the blood because of how necessary those elements of being hydrated really are. Just like the hydration for the body is relationship with God for the soul, and the need to live a life that is not of selfishness but of selflessness is just as important as hydration for the body. And it's, everybody is made for hydration. Everybody is made for this mission of the soul. And it's such a over and over the example that you described. You know, the wealthiest people, they've got everything. They've got everything at their fingertips, the biggest, beautiful, most beautiful houses, the nicest cars, and there's still something missing sometimes. I've seen people who are very wealthy who use their gifts for great reasons and to serve, and they're at peace. But they know, as many will say, you know, look, we know that you can't take it with you. There's never a U-Haul attached to your hearse. You know, you just don't take it with you. The Egyptians tried that. We dug up their tombs later. All their stuff was still there. So we know you can't take it with you. And those people who have that kind of wealth and use it for the glory of God to build the kingdom, they do find a sense of peace because they do know that it's a tool, it's been given to them, and they use it to build up the kingdom.